Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to configure product images into product feed. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. To test configuring our product images, let's go ahead and create a feed. Click on New Feed. United States is fine. Let's choose Custom Template 1. Let's give it a file name, Image Test 1. XML is fine, and I'll include all the variations. Let's scroll down and look at the attributes. The attributes we're looking at is image link, and the value it's returning is main image. Now the main image returns a specific product image if it's a single product. If it's a variable product, it will return the variable image. Otherwise, it will return the image of the parent variation. So let's go ahead and update this feed. Once it's ready, let's have a look. Here in our feed, the first product that we have is jeans. And the attribute main image is returning a specific product image, which is jeans.jpg. Now the next product that we have is not a simple product. This is a variable product. Right now we can see all the different variations available. We've got the t-shirt blue, green, and red. Let's see what value the main image is returning. It's returning t-shirt.jpg, t-shirt.jpg, and t-shirt.jpg. So it looks like it's returning the image for the parent variation, since all three are the same. Let's go back to our site and confirm this. Let's go back to products. As you can see, we've got jeans, which is a simple product, t-shirt. Right now, if you scroll down, we can see this is a variable product. And if we look at all the variations and drill into it, we can see that there's no image right here. Let's look at green, there's no image here as well. And for the last one, red, we have no image as well. That's why in our feed, the image it is returning is this, which is t-shirt.jpg and is the parent variation image. Let's upload some variation images for these variable products. So first you've got the blue shirt. Let's upload this, great. Next we have the green shirt. So we're going to upload the image for the green shirt, and last but not the least, we've got the red shirt. Perfect. Let's go ahead and update this. Now that our products are updated, let's go ahead and regenerate this feed. Let's go to manage feed. Let's update and generate this feed. Now let's take a look at the feed. Now as you can see, for our variation images, the blue shirt is picking up this image, blueshirt.jpg. The green shirt is picking up greenshirt.jpg. And last, we have the red shirt, which is picking up redshirt.jpg instead of picking up the parent variation image. Now there are other ways you can configure product images as well. Let's go ahead and look into it in our feed. Let's look into more attributes that you can use to display product images. Let's go add new attribute, featured image, and let's see if we can find it. There we go, featured image right here. Now featured image works like main image, but instead of the product variation image, it will return the parent variation image. So in this case, if we look at our product, even though under our variables right here we've got the variable images, it won't show that. It will be returning the image of the parent variation. Let's go ahead and test it out. Let's go back to manage feed. Let's keep it right next to our main image. Update and generate feed. Once it's ready, let's take a look. There you go guys. As you can see, even though we've got the variable images configured in our products, it's still returning the main parent variation image. We've got t-shirt.jpg here, t-shirt.jpg, and we've got t-shirt.jpg once again. So now you know how you can use the featured image attribute to show your images. Let's go ahead and look at more attributes. The next attribute we're looking at is images. So let's type that in. And there we go, images, comma separated. Now images return product gallery images separated by commas. Let's go ahead, update and generate this feed. Before we take a look at our feed file, let me show you a product that has gallery images. Let's go to products and let's look at hoodie with pocket. And here, if we scroll down, we can see that this is the product image, which is the main one, and this is the product gallery images. So right now we're expecting to see these two images in our feed. So let's go back here and have a look at our feed. There we go. In our feed, under images, we can see both of the product gallery images showing up. This is the first one, then you've got the comma separator, and we've got the second image showing up. If you want your images to show the main product image, and on top of it, you want to show the product gallery images as well, you have to use attribute mapping. So let's go down here. I've already named one of it, images main plus gallery. Attribute separator is comma. Let's add one. The first one is going to be the main image. There we go. And the next one is going to be images, which is going to pick up the gallery images. Let's go save mapping. Now we need to add this to our feed. Let's go ahead and add the new attribute that we have just created. Let's see if we can find it. There we go. Under attribute mapping, images, main and gallery. Update and generate this feed. Now if we take a look at our feed, we can see we've got the first image coming up, the main image, and then we've got the second one and the third one from product gallery images showing up. The next attribute we're looking at is additional image. So let's go add one and let's see if we can find the attribute right here. There we go. You can see that the additional images, there are a few of them. Additional images will return product gallery images. As you can see, they are numbered as well. So you can choose which number image you want to be returned to your feed. So let's say I'm going to choose one. Let's go ahead, update and generate this feed. Let's take a look at the feed. As you can see, for your hoodie with pockets, we've got an additional image and it's being returned as expected. For zipper with hoodie as well, we've got another additional image here and it's being returned as expected. If you want variation images to show up in your feed, you can use variation gallery image plugin. Some of the plugins that is compatible with CTX feed are additional variation images gallery for WooCommerce. And then we've got variation images gallery for WooCommerce. Last but not the least, we've got WooCommerce additional variation images. At this point, I've already installed this plugin in my site. So let's go ahead and add some variation images. Now we're inside the variable product. Let's scroll down and look at the variations. Let's look at the variation green. As you can see, since we have installed the plugin, we are able to add gallery images for our variation. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll go add gallery images. Let's add a different image here. Let's add a second variation of the green t-shirt. Let's go add images. Let's go ahead and update this. Now it's time to create the feed and see what it looks like. Let's go ahead and refresh our feed and let's take a look. Right now, if we look at our variation green, we can see under additional images, it's picking up the two new images that we've added under our variation gallery. We've got the variation t-shirt 1 and we've got the variation t-shirt 2. Now, if your variation does not have any variation images, instead it's going to return the product gallery images of the parent product. So right now, as you can see, for the blue variation, it does not have any variation images. That is why it is returning the product gallery image. Let's confirm this. If we go to a product, we can see that there's no gallery images for the blue t-shirt. That's why it is looking at the product gallery for the parent product and it's returning this, which is, in this case, t-shirt.jpg. There you go, guys. Now you know how you can configure product images into your product feed. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.